Our Danielle Lawan met with Savannah Chatham Metro Police and the Georgia State Patrol today. Danielle, pot can get you in just as much as trouble behind the wheel as you think it could.
That's right, Don. There are a few key differences, but overall, police tell me you're either impaired or you're not, even though marijuana is becoming legalized and decriminalized in areas across the country. And right here in Georgia, it's still illegal to drive high, and here's why.
As we continue to see state after state legalize or decriminalize pot, the messages might be getting crossed. Officers are starting to see a huge increase in the number of stoned drivers.
The DUI laws have not changed. You're either impaired or you're not.
Georgia State Patrol showed me just how they recognize what's impairing a driver.
Hey, sir, Trooper Chernick with the Georgia State Patrol. You have your license on you.
Here are the red flags that prompted the traffic stop.
First of all, you're falling behind that vehicle ahead of you, that red Toyota Camry. You're falling behind them awful closely. Kept tapping your brakes.
Chernick says driving is a divided attention task. In their test, they divide the driver's attention to see if they're able to multitask.
Put your feet together, heel to heel, toe to toe. Put your arms down by your side.
These sobriety tests go beyond walking a straight line. Their concept of time also dissolves.
With your eyes closed and your head tilted backwards, I need you to estimate the passing of 30 seconds in your mind.
30 seconds does not compute when a driver is stoned.
Mr. Smith, how did you come to that number?
Transportation studies show regular pot smokers will drive high 17 times per month. Tonight, I spoke with two drivers who confirmed that estimate and some.
How often would you say that you drive high?
Probably 70%, honestly, not lying.
Do you notice a difference when you drive sober and high?
I feel like I'm a better driver high.
How often would you say that you smoke?
Every day.
And how many times a day?
Probably two or three.
Do you think that your driving is as impaired as it is if you were to be drunk driving as you are high driving?
Oh, definitely not. I would never drunk drive. My motor skills are terrible. My motor skills don't change when I'm high.
People will have that false sense of confidence.
Confidence they see in both drunk drivers and high drivers.
Move your head, just about tip my fingers to your eyes, and allow your eyes to cross.
State Trooper Chernick tells me he's seen more cases of impairment driving high this past year than he ever has in his career. Dawn?